The title of the book was deliberately chosen to emphasize the belief that the combination of theory and practice result in a far more comprehensive understanding for a business world than mere attraction and theory. We from group 3 will discuss and provide a brief overview in this book on economic for business. This book consists 5 chapters, starting from chapter 1, which provides and explain about companies in its environment. Chapter 2 explain about of demand and supply. Chapter 3 explain the description of market and prices. Chapter 4 explain the picture of government, companies, and market. And the last chapter explain about analysis for business decision making.
In the chapter 6, discuss about a company to pursue goals non-profit, maximizing the force or max in major and oligopoly or monopoly, and capable of generating abnormal profits. Under such circumstances, the company have the attitude to become competently less efficient and stay afloat in the market. The constraint on management is market force. In very hard market competition, management must accept maximization profit. The constraint is less work, the competitive force weaker. However, the dominance of oligopolic market in the modern economy provides in room for non-profit maximizing behavior. However, strong competition in our market and companies cannot ignore efficiency and profitability. However, as we will see below, the advance now and there as constraint on before major and then the source of domination cause company. There are two generic type of alternative theories, namely, number 1, managerial theory, number 2, theory behavior. Managerial theory assumes the divorce of ownership from control in the starting point of false managerial theory. In such theories, profit therefore appears as a constraint on managerial behavior, behavioral theory on stratification again. It is assumed that are a separation of ownership from control. However, when managerial theory say management as having one goal of maximizing.
In the chapter 7 discusses about two approaches that have been used to describe and analyze a market or industry, the structure behavior performance approach and further 5 forces model. 7 this model incorporates the same elements as the SCP model but describes them under a different heading. The theoretical market structure in neoclassic economics, market structure basically means the number of firms operating in an industry. Of course, the market will have different characteristics and give rise to very different demand behavior. Its main advantage is that is a simple framework that is easy to understand and apply and is not industry specific and therefore can can be used in the different industries and to complement other purposes for comparison purposes. Exciting competition will be discussed in detail later in this chapter, but it must be remembered that even in industry with a small number of firms, exciting firms may operate in competition only because of the threat of competition.
In the chapter 8 discourse about a very useful toolkit for describing and evaluating intrusion for preventing behavior. Consider an industry where there are both incumbents and potential participants. Product differentiation can also be a part of a strategy to influence market condition and our means to gain a competitive advantage over other manufacturer in the industry. If a company succeeds in differentiating its product in the midst of consumers, it will give itself more and more power in the market. The other product levels can also be used to segment the market. They will assume different interests in different market segments. For example, the care market can be segmented into the economy class, family core, and luxury core. The product tiers can also be used in market segments as they will assume different benefits in different market segments. For example, the automotive market can be segmented into the segment economy, family, and premium. This form of product differentiation creates barriers to entry that reduce the potential for competition in the market. Boundary preaching is a preaching strategy designed to deter potential entrants and only barriers to entry can precise about contiguous breaches. If new entrants try to enter the market, incumbents can use predator breaching to pass new entrants out of the market and bring the market back into balance. Pre-breach is where the incumbent firm increases output and the debris lowers the market price by, so that a fierce loss only the largest targets can withstand this, and the market will return to its previous equilibrium.
Traditional examples about profit maximization constantly be questioned with respect to the ability and willingness of companies to pursue these goals. This question is particularly focused on the separation of ownership from control in modern joint stock companies and the possibility that constraints on manager will force them to maintain profit their objective. Managerial theory establishes alternative behavioral models assuming management seeks its own utility maximization or sales goal. The market structure is that considers in part using Vortex 5 force model and the ration for the high and low contraction levels are described as how traditional economy theory country on the query market structure the most important of behavior, and for men it is clear from this capture that RR factors its work such as the level of potential competition that market theory considers constable within the government's competition policy in the is now a greater expectation that market shall be constable rather than competitive. Several from mass indicator have been considered and a similar view has been drawn from this. These are not passive outcomes of behavior. They